Hallelujah. Okay. Now I want to show you how to reveal another thing for you. This one is where Christ Embassy Pastor Oyakhilome is, where he's paying his own tithe. Where he's paying his own tithe is what I want to reveal now. Oyakhilome there is never a time God called him. God not called. All these people are bloody men. There's never a time that God called this man. All of them want to do the work of God or calling God to enrich themselves. For their selfish purposes, for the wicked works they want to do. And that's why Nigeria is decaying. Nigeria is dead. Because these people are operating with the powers from the pit of hell. The place where Kilome is going to pay his own tithe is one dangerous place in River State called Oron. It's a very small village, Oron. This place, they are specialized, they make crayfish. They produce crayfish more from that side, not from two other side. But this place is inside Oron. They call it Oron. Try to make inquiry. You find out what I'm saying. You find out that there's a place called, ask somebody, make inquiry. If you know anybody from Riverside or from River State, Calabar side, you know, ask them, is there any place called Oron? And they will tell you. Ask them what is happening there. They will tell you. Oron. This place, they have a conch, witches and wizard, and they are in form of the goddess. They are water. They are from water. They are women. They are these ones are women. They are witches and wizard, and the goddess. Repeat it. The goddess, there's a river, as you understood, in that side. And this native doctor is a woman. It's a woman. And this is the place Oyakhilome normally visit once in a month to go and give one tenth, to go and pay his own tithe. He visits this place once in a month because they travel from place to place in search of power. But there is a particular place that they don't, when it comes to, they know that this place is the headquarter. But they are, you know, devil scatter himself everywhere. So they keep going places, you know, visiting places, gathering powers. But there's this place that they know as a headquarter that they we find and say, okay, this is a place where you know his own place. Like I said to you, Oyedepo own is in Cotonou. So this one own, according to how the direction or the connection they give them, this one own is at Cross River, Oron. The native doctor is a woman. He goes there for power. He goes there to have a meetings with them for them to release more power upon him for him to you know, to receive more power, to receive more evil power. He goes there with his own tithe, with his own one tenth. He visits them once in a month. I said to you, at Cross River State, you know, Cross River, you know, Calabar side, Oron. This is where this one is paying his own tithes. And they will come out and they're shouting tithe, because they are operating with it. I say to you that tithe, the devil is Mr. Law, the law. The devil is the one operating with law. So that's why they are crying for tithe, for tithe, for tithe, for tithe. Because if they did not receive that tithe from you and bring to the devil, you know, that given that power, they are in trouble. They can't operate in your life. They use it as computer to search, to work on the destiny of the people. They use that type that you give to them to operate in your destiny, to operate in your life. And the devil used to know the one with great destiny, the one with destiny. The one that they will suck their life, they'll drink their blood. The one that they will take their destiny and give to the rich people. Because in Nigeria, you can see the rich getting richer, the poor getting poorer. So the devil will know the one he will drink their blood from the tithe. The devil will know the one that is with great destiny, will take it from them and give to the rich people that is coming to them. They say, oh, hey, I went to this church and I become richer and I hit a contract. Why can't the poor people hit that contract? But the poor getting poorer, the rich getting richer, because they are feeding on your life. Stop giving your money to this bloody man. Stop giving your money to this Illuminati pastors. Stop giving your money to this occultic pastors. It is dangerous for you. It is dangerous for your life. So I just want to make it short for you to hear and understand what I'm saying. So, my duty, I am out. I told you, if I want to talk about what I saw in Nigeria and I'm still seeing, I can never run out. I will keep producing, making video every time. But I am taking it one by one, bringing it one by one, so that your eyes, so many of you that's been blinded, your eyes is been opening every day. It's opening more and more. No matter how they are attacking, no matter how they are fighting, truth prevails. Truth is power. Truth is life. Lies is but for a moment. But the truthful lives shall endure forever. So they are darkness fighting the light. But the Bible says that the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness cannot comprehend it. Truth is more powerful than lies. Light is more powerful than darkness. So victory is ours. No matter how these people try to grow themselves stronger in the end of the devil, this is their end. They can't proceed. They can't produce anymore. They can't proceed no longer. God has put an end to all this evil.